One very important concept that distinguishes one line from another is that line's slope, or leaniness, if you would.
Let's play. Here we go.
If we look at a line from left to right, and that's the way we read, so that makes sense. If we look at this line and we try to walk on it, I hope from left to right you can see quite easily that you're walking uphill. So the slope would be some positive number. Whereas if we looked at this line and once again walked left to right, we'd be going downhill. So I hope you appreciate that that would be a negative number or a negative slope. I bet you know what this slope is. It's a flat line. So that slope, though the number associated with the slope of that line, is zero. And there's only really one other possibility. A line that looks like this. And if you tried to walk on that line, you would fall, and you would fall forever, all the way through hell, past purgatory, and keep going. That's why we call that line, the slope of that line, undefined or infinite. Hopefully you get the idea. Numerically speaking, if you looked at this line and tried to walk on it, of course, it would be uphill and it would be a positive slope. This one would also be a positive slope, but it would be even steeper. So I hope you appreciate that would be a larger positive number if we tried to measure its slope, its leaniness. Whereas if we looked at this line and we tried to walk from left to right, we'd still be going downhill. That would be a negative slope. In fact, it would be negative 1/2. This line would have a slope that's even more negative, I hope you appreciate. And in fact, is a negative 3. That's a more negative slope. So where are we getting these numbers? What measures slope? What number? Well, it's going to stay the same no matter where we are on the line. So we should be able to pick any two points, and we can. Slope is defined between any two points as the amount you went up or down divided by or related to the amount you went left or right between those two points. In this case, to get from point 1 to point 2, walking from left to right, we went up 3 and over 1. So the slope is 3 over 1, or 3. The slope of this line, and I'll pick any two points, is not quite as high as 3, is it? I went up 1 for every one I went over 2. The slope is, in fact, the number 1/2, or 0.5, in this case. Now, as I told you before, it shouldn't matter which points I pick. So let's pick some different points. This one should certainly have a negative slope. It's going downhill. If I pick these two, the rise would really be a fall, and the run would be 3, and the slope would be negative 2/3. However, what if I picked these two points? I should get the same slope, shouldn't I? Well, between these two points, I went down 4, oh, it doesn't look good, and over 6. But if you take the fraction minus 4/6 and reduce it, you still get minus 2/3. So it doesn't matter which two points you pick. You should get the same slope, defined by the rise or fall over the run. Get the idea? Now, it's kind of a pain to draw these pictures. So there's going to be a formula you can use if I just give you the two points. Let's look at this line and these two points. Point 1 will be 0, 2, and point 2 will be 3, 4. Now, the rise, or the amount we went up, we know is 2. Where did that 2 come from? Well, couldn't you say that it came from the y part of the second point minus the y part of the first point, or in this case, 4 minus 2. Now you did that visually, but that's really what the rise was. And the run, the amount you went over, you counted the blocks, but couldn't you say, was the x part of the second point minus the x part of the first point, or in this case 3 minus 0. And we would get 4 minus 2 is 2, and 3 minus 0 is 3, and that in fact is the slope, up 2 and over 3. So you can get that without even looking at the picture by putting it into the formula y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. What if we start at the other point and work backwards? It'll still work. I'm going to let point 1 be 3, 4 this time and point 2 be 0, 2. This time I went down and y2 minus y1 would be 2 minus 4 rather than 4 minus 2. Now as long as you're consistent, we'll go back for the x's. I'll get x2 minus x1. This time we have a different second point, so we have 0 minus 3 instead of 3 minus 0. And if you think about it, 2 minus 4 is negative 2, and 0 minus 3 is negative 3, and if we reduce that, we still get 2/3. So it doesn't matter which point is point 1 and which point is point 2. Even if we use completely different points on this line, let's use negative 3, 0 and 3, 4. Now you got to be careful with your negatives, but our rise will be y2 minus y1, which is 4 minus 0 in this case, over our run, which will be careful, x2 minus x1 is 3 minus, you have to subtract, the negative 3. Remember, when we subtract a negative, what happens? We're going to get 4 minus 0 is 4, and 3 minus negative 3, the two negatives become a positive, we get 6.
Is that your final answer?
No, we always have to reduce. And son of a gun, we still get 2/3.
Code red, repeat. We are code red. Now what am I gonna do?
It would even work for this line, but I bet you already know what the answer is in this case, if you understand the concept of slope. But let's pick two points, 6-1 and 2-1, and put it into the formula. Pretend we didn't see the picture. y2 minus y1 would be 1 minus 1. And x2 minus x1, or x part of the second point minus x part of the first point, would be 6 minus 2. And if we calculate it, 1 minus 1 and 6 minus 2, you already knew the answer looking at the picture was 0, because it's a flat line. What about this one? Pick two points. Do you remember what you should get as an answer for this? Well, let's see. y2 minus y1 in this case is going to be 4 minus 1 over x2 minus x1, which is 3 minus 3. What happens here? 4 minus 1 is 3, but 3 minus 3 is 0. 3 over 0 is undefined, isn't it? We can't have 0 in the denominator. So that's why this slope is undefined. And if you tried to walk on the line, remember, you'd fall forever. So it really makes a lot of sense. I propose to you that if I gave you one point and a slope of a line, that you could draw that line on a graph. Let's draw the graph of a line containing the point 0, 2. We know where that is. Go over 0 and up 2. And execute the slope minus 1 over 2. Minus 1 over 2. That means between any two points, I'm going to go down 1 and over 2. Well, they gave me a point. 0, 2. So from there, I'll go down 1 and over 2, and I must be at another point on the line. And if I have two points, I know where the line is. So that's an easy way, if they give you one point and the slope, to draw a line. Let's do another one. Let's draw the graph of a line containing the point 1, 1, over 1 and up 1, with a slope of 3. Now that's a little screwy, but you need to remember that the number 3 as a fraction is 3 over 1. So we go up 3 and over 1. And we have the other point, and once we have two points, we can draw the line. Let's work backwards. You give me the slope of this line. Now you're going to have to pick two points. Pick good points, easy points, ones that are on corners so that they have whole number coefficients. I'm going to pick this one and this one. Now visually you can tell me what the rise and what the run is. Between one point and the other, I went down 1 and over 3. So guess what the slope is? It's not that hard. What about this one? I think the hardest part is picking easy points. If I pick those two, between those two points, my rise would be 2 and my run would be 1. So there it is. The slope is 2 over 1 or 2. What if I use different points? What if I use this point and this point? I should still get the same answer, and I do. Between those two points, I go up 4 and over 2. 4 over 2 still equals 2 if you reduce. You always have to remember to reduce, and they may not tell you that.
Excuse me, Professor Brainiac.
I want to lead you into the next lesson before we take a break here. And I'm only going to give you an equation. And I want you to tell me what the slope is. The equation is y equals 2x minus 1. Now you consider that you could use that equation to get two points. Let's get two easy points. I'm going to put in my easiest number. I'm going to put in a 0 for x, because this is already solved for y. And y will be, in that case, 2 times 0 instead of x minus 1. And 2 times 0 minus 1 is minus 1. And what's the next easiest number I could put in? I'll put in a 1. And 2 times 1 instead of x is 2 minus 1. Y is 1. So now I've used the equation. I have no picture, mind you. I've used the equation to find two points. And once I have two points, I can use the formula. Y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. In this case, we'll say 0.1 is 0, negative 1, and 0.2 is 1, 1. So I'll go the y part of the second point minus the y part of the first, be careful with the negatives there, over the x part of the second point minus the x part of the first point. And I get, be careful, 1 minus a negative 1 is 2. And 1 minus 0 is 1. And son of a gun, in this case, only given the equation, I know that it's 2. Now, next time is going to be a way easier way, given the equation, to find out that that slope is 2.
Scotty,
for now, go do your homework.